Hello, namaste, and welcome to today's class. So today we're going to be working with Kapha in the system of Ayurveda. This is the season of Kapha. We're recording this class at the beginning of March. And Kapha is made up of the elements of earth and water. And all of us have this particular dosha of Kapha, the earth and the water, but some of us have it in different quantities. So what happens to majority of us in the spring is these heavy elements of earth and water mixing together to form mud can make us feel a little bogged down. And as we move out of the that season of rest and almost like hibernation of winter, and we move into the season of spring, it can be hard for our endocrine system to catch up and to move into this new rhythm of a little more vigor in the spring. So we're going to be working because Kapha is mucus, and it's the seat of Kapha is basically the stomach and the lungs and the sinuses. And many of us might find that in the spring we get those colds or we get those sinus issues or that cough or that phlegm. And so we're working with the lungs and opening the heart center, as well as building a little bit of heat or tapas to purify and to start to move that excess heavy energy of Kapha out. So we're actually going to get started in standing. And you can see I'm already standing with my feet wide. So come to stand on your mat facing the long side of your mat. Sorry, I just have to see what time we're starting so I don't go too long. And with your feet out at a 45 degree angle, so not completely parallel, but just out slightly. And we're going to come into goddess pose, which is a strengthening, grounding pose, but it also helps us as we bend our knees. You can bring your hands to your abdomen, and you can even bring your index finger and thumb together to place over the abdomen and let your knees track in the same direction as your feet as your base moves closer to the earth. Now, this really energizes the lower body and starts to build some warmth, as well as starts to activate the floor and the base of the pelvis, where we can release some creativity, because when Kapha is heavy and stagnant in the spring, we can lack that get up and go and that inspiration. So we're going to spark a little bit of that creative inspiration with Kapha Bali breath as we come into our goddess pose or fiery angel. So sink low, and you can even engage the pelvic floor just a little bit, not super overdoing it. And we'll start with our Kapha Bali. So keep going with that snap of the breath, snap of the belly back to force the breath out. This is a purification breathing technique, and it helps to clear out all that stagnancy, both energetically as well as physically. So keep going. And it's not how fast you're going, keep going. It's not how fast you're going, but it's the quality of the breath that you're creating, of that snap. That's a snap, that it's crisp and it's clean. And then on your next inhale, release the arms, reach up to the air, bring your thumbs to touch, and hold, retain the inhale. You can have eyes open or closed as you retain the breath here. When you need to release, straighten the legs, release the arms down, and just pause and feel the energetic effect of that purification breath, helping to clear out that stagnancy, beginning to create some heat, and begin to release some of that cold clamminess that comes with Kapha, releasing some of that stagnation. We're going to do another round just like that. So take a couple more breaths here, breathing into the low belly. And if you want to bring your hands, either just palms on the low belly, or bring the thumbs and index fingers to touch once again. And then we're going to take one more inhale, You can do exactly the same as we did the first round. As we exhale, bend the knees, come into your goddess pose. You can engage slightly in the pelvic floor and begin at your speed when you're ready with Kapha Bali, with that snap of the belly back to force the breath out. One more round, and then inhale, straighten the legs, reach up, thumbs to touch. Retaining the breath at the top of the inhale. And then slowly release, let the arms come down, and pause for a moment just to feel the effect. Perhaps feeling a little bit of warmth beginning to arise. Maybe feeling your breath flow a little more easily. And then let's heel, toe, your feet together. And just come into mountain pose for a moment. So feel into your feet and feel that connection to the earth energy, but bring your awareness to the inhale and that lift and rise of the inhale that helps to lift us out of the stagnation, to that feeling of being mired in the muck. And then we're going to begin with some kind of slow sun salutations to get the body moving. Oops. And move into our practice, our Kapha practice. So let's begin just with some breath initially. Just moving our arms like a half sun salutation. So as we inhale, bend your knees, reach up, stretch up, press your palms up to the sky. Sorry, I got myself a little too close as you reach up. And then exhale, release the hands down. Let's just do that two more times, getting the breath moving. Inhale, reaching up, intertwine the fingers, press palms up. And exhale, release down. One more time, just like that. Inhale, reach up, intertwine the fingers, press the palms up to the sky. This time as we exhale, we're going to release the hands and fold forward. The inhale, we float the heart up. We lift the chest, bring the torso parallel to the floor. Knees can be bent here so that you can have a nice flat back. And exhale. Fold forward, let your top of your head fold towards the earth, and then press into both feet and rise up away from that earth and reach up to the sky. Press your palms up to the sky, and then release your arms to circle wide, bring them back to your heart center. We're going to do that two more times, just that exact same thing, just getting the breath and the body moving. Inhale, reach up, press your palms up to the sky. And as you exhale, circle your arms wide and fold forward, bending your knees as much as you need to. On the inhale, allow the buoyancy of the breath to lift your heart and lengthen in opposite directions. Exhale, bow, bend your knees, press into the earth and press away, lift high, lift your spirits, lift your body, reach to the sky, press your palms up and circle your arms wide. Come back to heart center. One more time, this time we're going to add on. So inhale, reach up, intertwine the fingers, press palms up. Exhale, circle the arms wide as we fold. Inhale, hands to your shins, blocks or fingertips to your mat as you lengthen. Exhale, bow down, hands can come either to your blocks or to your mat, and step your right foot to the back of your mat. We're just going to get the body moving, beginning to open and create some movement of energy to release the stagnation. So just start with rocking back and forth. And you're pressing that front thigh down towards the earth at the same time the back thigh's moving up. Take an inhale, look forward, reach forward, exhale, reverse lunge. Inhale forward, exhale. Back. One more time. Inhale forward,
Exhale back. Actually, let's do it two more times, a little faster. Inhale forward. Exhale back. Last time, inhale forward. Exhale back. Inhale forward. Turn your toes to the long side of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, bend your right knee. Walk your hands over. Bring a stretch into the side body as you reach your fingers diagonally. So we're going to be doing some back bends, and we want some space in between those intercostal muscles, between the ribs. Inhale, halfway lift, straight arms. Back to center. Exhale to your left. Same thing. Reach those fingers diagonally as far away from you as you can to bring that stretch in the side body. One more time to each side. Center. On the inhale. Exhale to the right. Bending that right knee. Stretch through the side. Inhale, center. Exhale, left. Inhale, center. Let's walk it back to the top of our mat. Pivot. And then plant your right hand either on the mat or on your block. We're going to reach left hand to the sky. Draw the belly to the left. Reach that left hand up. Really activate this right arm and right leg. And maybe you even look up to the sky here. And then try to integrate the arms into the shoulders. So one arm is stacked right over top of the other. One more breath here. And exhale, release. Let's step it back, downward facing dog. Walk your dog out, bring a little movement. Movement helps that stagnation, that feeling of being stuck for Kapha. And then let's drop to the knees for cat-cow. Again, just getting the breath moving and getting the front body beginning to open. So we inhale, opening the front of the spine, and exhale, navel draws towards the spine, press the earth away from you. Two more times, inhale, and exhale. Finding your ujjayi breath here for one more round. If you haven't already started utilizing that, it's the warming, heating breath. And then let's lift the knees, find your way back into downward facing dog. We're going to do some plank accordions, I call them. So we're going to come forward into our plank pose. Adjust the distance between hands and feet if you need to. And then we're going to just bend our knees over to the right. So I'm squished, pressing the top of my mat away. My knees are pointing over to the right side of my mat. And then I'm going to spring forward and press back, knees to the left. Spring forward, just like our clocks are going to be doing soon. Press back to the right. Spring forward, knees to the left as you press back. One more time each side. Press forward, back. Spring forward, and last time to the left. And come forward to your plank. Now you can lower from full plank. If you've got shoulder issues or you're building strength, you can lower your knees and lower down partway. Even if you can't do chaturanga, pause, and then lower the rest of the way. Helps you to build that strength. So let's open the heart, lift the heart in our cobra pose. Exhale, come down. Draw your hands back so that they're beside your side ribs, so that your arms are in more of a 90 degree angle, and create that traction as though you're pushing your hands back towards your back of your mat. Lift the heart and really lengthen through the legs. Tops of the toes are pressing down. Exhale, release down. Bring the hands out to the side on your fingertips. Elbows bent, pointing up to the sky. Inhale, roll up. A modified cobra or a cobra variation. Exhale, release down. Hands under your shoulders. Curl the toes under. You press up and back, either straight to down dog. Some of you might want to take a little pause in child's pose to release any tension in your back.
fact, let's all come down to child's pose, actually. And bring your hands to extend towards the top of your mat and come onto your fingertips so that your elbows and your forearms are lifted and your palms are lifted. Just your fingertips are down on the mat. And maybe try to walk your fingertips a little closer to the top of your mat. And then see if you can walk your palms together and bend at the elbows so that your fingertips point up to the sky. So this gets into the lateral muscles alongside the outer shoulder blade and a little bit into the upper back. And then release your palms down.
Let's find our way back into downward facing dog. And remember, we have a second side that we have to do. Let's take one inhale in your down dog, bend your knees, look to the top of your mat, step, walk, or float to the top of your mat. Inhale, lengthen as your heart lifts and you lengthen through the crown. Exhale, bow, bend your knees, press the earth away from you as you rise up. Intertwine your palms, intertwine your fingers, press your palms to the sky. And release, nice big wide circle, expansive, hands to heart center. Take a breath or two in your mountain pose. And we'll prepare to do our second side. Inhale, reach up, intertwine the palms, press, intertwine the fingers, press palms up. I keep wanting to say that same mistake. Exhale, circle wide as you bow to the earth, bend your knees if you need to. Inhale, lift the heart, lengthen, and this time left foot steps back. So we're coming into that same lunge position, and we're going to do that transition with the breath between this lunge and reverse lunge. So take an inhale, reach your heart forward as you extend that back leg strongly back, and as you exhale, reverse lunge. Inhale forward, exhale. Inhale using your ujjayi, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, last one, exhale. This time as we inhale forward, we're gonna walk, turn to the long side of our mat and repeat. I'm sorry, I'm not switching sides, so you get the back view. So lengthen like you're doing a halfway lift on your fingertips here. Exhale, bend your left. Reach way over to the left side. Stretch through the side body. Inhale to center. Exhale to the right. And maybe you want to bring your hands up off the floor and just reach to the, out to the side. Come back through center and exhale to the other side. Come back to center, release your hands to the floor. Let's pivot to the top of our mat. Plant that left hand on your block or on your mat and inhale. Belly's twisting to the right, arm is lifting up to the sky. You might even have that hand on your hip if you've got some shoulder issues, but I'm looking to try to have my top arm stacked right over my bottom arm. So my arm's not going way back, but it's staying in line with the bottom arm. Maybe your gaze drifts up to the sky, to an expansive sky, which helps to alleviate the heaviness of Kapha. Take one more breath here and release the hand down. Let's step back. Downward facing dog. Are you ready to warm up with some tapas with our plank accordions? Really help clear the sinuses and the lungs. So come forward to plank. Bend your knees to the right as you press the top of your mat away from you. Belly towards your thighs. Inhale, spring forward. Exhale, knees left. Inhale, spring forward. Exhale. Press back. Spring forward, last one. Exhale, press back. This time as we spring forward, we come into our plank And again, if you're building up your strength, maybe this time we only drop one knee as we slowly lower, maybe pause, and then lower all the way down. And let's come into some more of our back bends. So extending arms straight out in front of you. We've done this before in class, those of you who practice with me often. So we're going to do opposite arm, opposite leg. So let's start with left arm and right leg. So as we inhale, we lengthen left arm, right leg. And as we exhale, press the earth away from you and lift that arm and leg up. Stay here as you inhale, expand. Exhale, we release back to the earth. Let's do our second side. The inhale, we lengthen. The exhale, we press up. Stay for the inhale. Exhale, release down. One more time to each side. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, lift up. Stay for an inhale. Release down on the exhale. Last one. Right arm, left leg lengthens on the inhale. Exhale, we press up, lift up. Stay for the inhale and release on the exhale. Bring your hands under your shoulders. Let's rise up. You can rise up into cobra. Some of you might want to press up into upward facing dog. And then we'll all meet back in down dog. Some of you might want to pause in child's pose before you find your way into downward facing dog. Inhale, exhale here. Take one more inhale, bend your knees, look to the top of your mat, step, walk, or float to the top of your mat. Inhale, lift your heart, lengthen through the crown. Exhale, bend your knees, press away from the earth as you circle wide and rise up, intertwine your fingers, press palms to the sky, and circle wide, bring it back into your heart center. Let's take a couple of breaths in your mountain pose, and then we're going to move into a standing series of poses. Actually, no, we're going to move into a series of lunges and twists and then into our standing series. So let's begin as though we were doing another sun salutation, but we're moving through our series of lunges. Let's inhale, reach to the sky. And as we exhale, fold, circle your arms wide, bring them down to the mat. Inhale, hands to shins or to fingertips as you lengthen halfway. Let the heart be buoyant. And exhale, let's step right foot back. So we're coming into our lunge here. And then we're going to drop the back knee and raise the arms to the sky. Come into our lunge. Intertwined fingers, press palms up to the sky here. Take one more breath. And as we release, we circle the arms wide, we bring them back to heart center, and I realize now I'm facing the wrong way, but that's okay, you'll see both sides. Inhale, lengthen your spine, lean forward a little bit. We're twisting to our left, so you might catch your elbow on that front knee. Some of you might just bring forearm to that knee and your left hand to your hip as you twist left. So whichever position you've taken with the hands, either palms together in prayer or to hip and knee, curl your back toes under if they're not already curled under, and see if you can make this transition of straightening that back knee. So we come into staying in our twist, but just lifting the back knee. If that's too much, keep that back knee down or release your hands to the mat to make that transition of lifting that back knee. Now we're gonna do another tricky transition here. You're probably feeling some heat building. Look towards your front foot. See if you can stay in your twist. We're gonna step forward into revolved chair pose. So we're gonna step that back foot to meet our left foot in our revolved chair. Take an inhale here. Release to center.
chair pose, and then rise up, press your palms all the way up, press the earth away from you as you lengthen, lengthen up, and circle your arms wide, come back to your heart center. So we're gonna do that same little sequence of transitions on your second side. And I should have said, have your blocks at the top if you wanna use blocks. And I hope you guys all got that choice for your twist of forearm here and your left arm on the hip. And you can bring your hands down to transition and come back into your twist if that's helpful for you. Let's go ahead and do second side. You should be feeling some warmth building. It's really cold in the studio and I'm feeling some warmth, so I hope you are at home as well. This helps to move that kapha and get the stuck energy and stagnation moving. Inhale, reach up to the sky. Exhale, bow. Inhale, lift halfway. And as we exhale, we step left foot to the back of the mat. Drop the back knee on an exhale. And inhale, reach to the sky. Intertwine your palm, your fingers, press palms up. And open the heart, even lifting your gaze, which helps to lift our energy. If we're feeling that stuckness, this helps lift us out of the mire of the mud. And then as we release, we circle the arms wide. Come back to your heart center. And now we're gonna twist to the right. So again, your options, keep your hands at heart center as you twist, or release forearm to the knee, hand to the hip as you twist. Both of them are appropriate. So remember, we're gonna see if we can transition to lift that back knee. So curl the back toes under. Maybe you look towards your front foot as you transition just to help you with balance. Lift the back knee. Find your breath here, whichever variation of the twist your hands are in. And now we're gonna see if we can step forward. I feel like I'm spread out really wide. This is gonna be a tough transition for me. See if we can step forward into our revolved chair. So look at your front foot. Bend that back knee a little bit. That was a messy transition, but we made it. So now you're in your revolved chair pose. Take one breath here. And then release to center. Palms are together. We press our palms together, press the earth away. Rise up, lift up, reach to those expansive skies. And circle your arms wide. Feel that sense of expansiveness. Come back to heart center. Take a couple breaths here. Notice the heat rising. Notice the breath flowing. And then I'm gonna ask you to step one foot back so that you come into a nice wide stance facing the long side of your mat. This is where we started. This time your feet are parallel. So we're coming into five-point star. So you can have your toes out just slightly and reaching your arms out at a 45 degree angle up towards the sky. This is a very expansive feeling posture. You can close your eyes if you wish, or keep them open, your choice. But feel that strength of the earth beneath you, the energy rising to your pelvis, and then all the way up to your navel center, your power center. And as you exhale, feel that energy spread out through your whole body, through your arms. Feel that expansiveness through your heart center. Feel that flow of energy from one hand through the heart center, through the other, through the heart center. Really extend in all directions in this five-point star. And even though it looks like a simple pose, if you're really extending, watching your energy flow with your mind's eye, you're gonna start to feel a lot happening here in this very simple pose. Take one more breath. And then we're gonna move into warrior two. So turn your left toes to the top of your mat. Bring your arms parallel. If you need to, release your arms for a second. And then bring them back up to parallel. Go ahead and do so. And then bend into that front knee. Find your strength and stability. But let's bring some movement into our upper body. Let's just start with this. Inhaling, reaching forward. So over that front thigh. And then exhaling, reaching back so that shoulders stack over your hips. Inhale, reach forward. Exhale, reach back. Inhale, reach forward. Exhale, reach back. And let's stay here with shoulders stacked over hips. Flip your front palm. Inhale, peaceful warrior. Now we're going to transition from peaceful warrior to side angle three times. So take one more inhale here. The exhale, we move into side angle, bringing movement into the upper body. Inhale, peaceful warrior. Exhale, side angle. Inhale, peaceful. And exhale, side angle. Let's pause here for a moment. Really lengthen. Look up to the sky. Find that length and openness in the upper body, expansiveness through the heart center. Take one more breath. And let's inhale, come all the way up. Let's come back into our five-point star. Lift your arms, close your eyes if you wish, or keep them open. Feel that energy flowing. You might even feel more expansive through your heart center, through your torso, through your upper back than you did before we just went through that series. I won't keep you here real long, but let's take one more breath here. And then bring your arms parallel or release them as you shift to your Warrior Two stance on your second side. So right toes to the top of your mat, arms parallel to the floor. Let's do that same back and forth in our Warrior Two, bringing a little bit of movement. Inhale, reach forward with that right arm. Exhale, reach back with the left. Inhale, forward. We'll do this three times. Exhale, reach back. Inhale, reach forward. Exhale, reach back, and then stay here. So shoulders are stacked over hips once again. Now we'll go through our peaceful warrior and side angle transitions three times. So flip the front palm, inhale to peaceful warrior, open that right side body as you look up to the sky. The exhale brings you into side angle. Circle that back arm up and over so palm faces the floor. Get a nice stretch. Inhale, peaceful warrior. So your arms are kind of like windmills here, moving that air. And one more time to peaceful warrior. And exhale into your side angle. And here we're going to stay. You could rotate your heart up to the sky, rotate your gaze to the sky, and really lengthen through that top arm. Feel that spaciousness, that length, that space between your ribs. Perhaps a little more openness through the heart center. Take one more breath here. And then our inhale, we rise up. We come back, bring your feet parallel this time, and this time let your arms rest. If you've been really using your arms to stay active in the upper body, you probably feel a little bit of a buoyancy in the heart and the shoulders and the upper back, like a balloon filled with air, perhaps feeling like you're floating up just a little bit, even though your feet are still on the ground. Close your eyes and feel that expansion like a brilliant blue sky in your upper body. And then let's come into a forward fold. Let's bring a little more stability into our body. There was a lot of uprising energy there. We can either intertwine fingers or press your fist together behind your back. Whichever is most appropriate for shoulders and what's going on in your body today. But whichever you're doing, inhale, lift your heart, lift your gaze. And as we exhale, we begin to keep lengthening, keep lengthening, keep lengthening, and then let the top of the head drop towards the earth. A little micro bend in your knees, and let the heart be open here. But try not to create tension in your neck by releasing the head. Maybe turn your head from side to side a little bit here. Take one more breath in your forward fold. And then we're going to lift halfway. So coming halfway up as you inhale, stay here for an exhale. And then inhale, come all the way up. Release your arms. Take a moment just to notice, feeling even more buoyancy in the upper body, the heart, the shoulders, the upper back. Beautiful. Okay, let's just step our feet together. You can come to the top of your mat. I'm going to stay right here for this next little series. So we're going to come into Eagle Pose. So Eagle Pose is really great for not only finding our balance, but also for opening the back body. And as we come into Eagle, our front body can feel very closed in. And when we release, when we feel the opposite of being scrunched up and then releasing, we can really feel that expansive properties that that the pose can bring for us. So we're going to start with chair pose, building a little bit of warmth. And then we'll move into Eagle Pose and Warrior Three. You can have some blocks at the top of your mat if you wish. So as we inhale, let's reach the hands up to the sky, bring your palms together in prayer. And as you exhale, sit down as though you're coming into chair pose, but we're not going in for a real deep chair. And then press up, reach up and circle wide, come to your heart center. So we're going to do that exact same little movement transition two more times. So inhale, reach up, palms come together. Exhale, sit down, but we keep the arms reaching high, creating that lift. Press into the earth, press the earth away from you, reach even higher, circle wide, come back to your heart center. One more time, inhale. Exhale, sit down. Keep reaching the fingertips up. So even though we're getting closer to earth, we've got that rising air energy here. And then draw your hands to your heart center. And then I'm going to bring right arm under left. I'm still sitting in chair. So you can grab your opposite shoulders. You can press the back of your palms together. Some of you might be able to wrap and bring your palms together. And then we're going to just slide that right leg over the left. So you can use your toes to help you stay in your balance here. You might wrap your foot around the calf. But take an inhale here. Lift your heart a little bit. Lift your elbows a little bit. Lengthen through your spine. As you exhale, we're going to bring elbows towards the knees. We're going to compact everything. We're going to become small. And feel, we're really working with our internal organs and some of our lymphatic system. As we compress, take an inhale, exhale out, and then on our next inhale, we're going to rise back up into our eagle. Release that top leg. I don't know if I can even make this transition. And step back into Warrior Three. Whoa! And then release your hands to your blocks or to your mat into standing splits. You might walk your hands back. Take one more breath. And then release that foot to meet your left foot. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, bow, press into the earth, press the earth away, come all the way up, drawn to your heart center. Let's take a breather here before we do our second side. Find your ujjayi breath if you've lost it. Smooth inhale, smooth exhale. Are you feeling the warmth? Really feeling that tapas, that purification of the heat happening in the body? So let's go ahead and do our second side. We're going to do the warm-up the same as we did for the first side. So that's inhaling, reaching to the sky, bringing palms together. Exhale, sitting down in a high, on a high chair. Press the earth away from you as you reach higher. Circle your arms wide and expansively. Come to your heart center. Two more like that, and the third one will stay in our chair to move into our eagle pose. Inhale, circle wide. Palms together, sit down in your chair. Again, we're not going super low. Just find your strength here. And then press the earth away as you rise up and circle wide and expansive back to your heart center. This is the one where we're going to stay. Inhale up. Exhale, sit. Stay here for an inhale as you reach up in opposition of the body moving towards the earth. And then bring your hands to your heart center. This time, left arm is going to come under right. So again, your options are opposite shoulders. Press the back of the hands together, or bring your wrap around for your palms to come together. Sorry, my knee is stuck. So now left leg comes over the right. And again, you can wrap around the calf. You can use your toe to help support you, because we're going to go through that same movement of moving elbows towards the knees. So take an inhale, lift your elbows, lift your heart, exhale, belly moves towards the spine as we slowly, slowly fold into ourselves, become small, and actually compress the abdomen. So we're compressing a lot of areas where there's lymphatic glands here. Take one more breath and use your next inhale to slowly come back up into your upright eagle, and then see if you can make that transition into warrior three as the left leg reaches out behind you. Take one more breath. Release. You know I'm so graceful at these balance poses. Release into your standing split, so your hands might be on your blocks, or you might walk your hands behind you as you lift that back leg. Let the top of your head spill. One more breath and release. Left foot comes to meet the right. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, bow. And inhale, rise and reach up, drawn to your heart. Take a breather in your mountain pose. Take a moment to notice all that energy, that warmth, that tapas, that purification of the heat and the fire moving through the body. And we're going to come into kind of a chair pose one more time. This time it's going to be a nice low chair pose. So let's inhale, reach to the sky, hands to your heart center as you exhale and sit down and sit really, really low. Release your hands to wrap around behind your knees and then sit as low as you can. So it's like you're compressing your belly into your thighs, the back of your knees compressed into your arms. And then begin to lengthen as though you're trying to lift your heart away from this compression. And at the same time, you're sending your tailbone back so they're moving in opposite directions. So it doesn't look like I'm doing a lot, but I'm really working to move my heart and my tail away from one another. And then release. Lift the hips, come into your forward fold. We're going to do another variation of that by bringing our feet wide on the mat.
And we're going to bring the arms between the legs and grab your heels or the outside of your foot and bring your tail towards the earth. So again, there's a lot of compression here. And then I'm going to lift my heart as though I'm trying to move my heart away from my tail and my tail away from my heart. So there's a lot of opposition of movement as well as compression happening in this pose. And I can feel a lot of heat moving in my body here. Take one more breath. And then inhale, lift the hips, release your hands, walk your feet back in. And let's step back into downward facing dog. Come forward to plank. Lower down, however you wish to lower down this time. And we're going to come into either Salabhasana or a bow pose. So you choose. Salabhasana is this guy. So releasing the hands alongside your hips, have your palms facing your hips. And then inhale, lift the heart, lift the arms, lift the legs. This is your Salabhasana, okay? If you're going into bow, bend the knees, grab onto the ankles. Try to keep your knees relatively close together rather than splaying them out really wide. And if you normally lift your heart first and then lift your legs, try keeping your forehead down, lift your legs first, and then lift the upper body, just to try something new. We're gonna stay for 3 breaths, whichever variation you're doing. Inhale, feel the breath pour into the heart center. Exhale, feel your belly move away from the floor. 2 more breaths like that, let it pour in. One more. And then release down. Stack your hands under your forehead. Rest your head on your back of your hands. Breathe into your belly. Feel your breath flow in. Feel your breath flow out. Couple more breaths here. Really feeling the belly move against the earth, press away from the earth. And then hands under your shoulders, find child's pose when you're ready. From our child's pose, you're going to make your way onto a seat. And we're just going to activate the core a little bit more. Sometimes in this time of year, this Kapha season, we need a little bit more willpower. We need a little bit more fire. We need a little bit more get up and go. And that comes from our belly center. So, knees bent, soles of the feet on the mat to start. You can keep your toes on your mat. I'll show you a couple variations here. You can keep your toes on your mat and just reach your arms forward. And actually, let's reach fingertips up to the sky. So you can do this. You can let your knees come apart if that works better for you. And then bring your both arms to the outside of your right knee. You can press your right knee into your elbow and your elbow into your knee. You'll feel your core activate. Come back to center and keep reaching as though you're pressing the air away and trying to keep your spine tall rather than leaning back. And then over to the left side. You can press your knee into your elbow, elbow into your knee. Come back to center and release. Take a little break. You can wrap both arms around your knees and inhale nice and tall. Exhale, lean back. Release. Inhale tall. Exhale, release. Now we're going to do that same thing, but we're going to lie on our back.
So, shins are parallel. We're going to start with arms straight and your fingertips again reaching up. So you're going to lift as though, actually let's keep our feet together and reach between our knees. So let your arms come inside your knees. Press your knees into your elbows and your elbows into your knees so they're in opposition. And lift, 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 belly button towards your spine. And then bring your knees together, both hands to the outside on the right. Press your knee into your elbow, elbow into your knee. Cross over center to the other side. Press knee and elbow. Come back to center. Open the knees, press, lift. Press knees into elbows, elbows into knees. And release it down. Feet come down, knees are still bent. Arms wide. Feel expansive. Feel open. And then we're simply going to let our knees drop over to the right. If you want to shift your knees left before you drop your knees, go ahead and do that. And let your head roll opposite your knees. And just let this be passive now. We're winding it down. Getting ready for Shavasana. Coming back to center. Shift your hips. If you've shifted over to the other side, let your knees drop left. Let your head roll opposite your knees. And again, your arms are expanded. Your palms are facing up. And come back to center. And we've got one more little back bend and inversion. you can have a block. We're going to come into legs up after our bridge pose. So if you want, you can slide a block under your hips. I'll grab my block after you're coming out of bridge. Some of you, if you have shoulder stand in your repertoire of poses, I'm not going to teach shoulder stand online because I feel like that's something that needs to be taught in person. But if you regularly do shoulder stand and you want to take shoulder stand, you will have an opportunity for that as well. So let's come into bridge to start. Heels towards your sit bones so that they're right under, your ankles are right under your knees. And then press the floor away as you lift your hips up on an inhale. You can walk your shoulders, your outer arms under the shoulders, intertwine fingers and press down into the floor as you lift up. Or you can have bent elbows with fingertips reaching to the sky, pressing elbows into the floor. So let's take a couple breaths here. This is really good for balancing our endocrine system to bring some compression into the thyroid at the base of the neck. And then if you want to move into a supported bridge, bring the block under your sacrum, the bony part of the back of your pelvis. You can also put a blanket over your block. And then when your hips are comfortably resting, you can raise the soles of your feet to the sky. Those of you who have shoulder stand in your repertoire, you can go ahead and move into your shoulder stand now. And the rest of us are going to be in this supported semi-shoulder stand. So we've got this inversion where all the lymphatic fluid in our legs, and we have a lot of lymph glands in the back of our knees, in the groin, can all drain into the main lymph in the chest. So just let this relaxing pose do its work for you for a few more breaths. Yeah. Let's have five more breaths here. So those of you who are in shoulder stand, when we release out of this pose, we are going to move into fish pose or a variation of fish pose. So you can prepare to move into that. Those of us that have our pelvis up on the blocks, we'll take a little longer to transition. And we can do that by starting to bend our knees and bring one foot and then the other foot down to the mat. And when you feel ready, lift the hips as though you're moving into bridge again. Slide your block out and let your hips come down on your mat and just pause for a moment. And then if you're not in fish pose, those of you that were in shoulder, bring your palms underneath your sacrum, straighten your legs, and we're going to come up onto our elbows. And then we're going to shift back and let the heart open and lift the heart. So I'm not just sliding back, I'm lifting my heart and sliding back, pointing my toes, and the top of my head moves towards the earth. I'm not really resting my head on the mat, but it's moving in that direction. So this is really opening in the throat, in the thyroid, in contrast to the compression that we just had in our previous pose, and very open on the heart. And whenever you feel you're ready to release, tuck your chin, bring your back down, release your arms out, straight out from your side, and we're going to make our way into Shavasana. So after this class of really working to find expansiveness in the chest, you might want to bring your arms straight out from your shoulders and just continue, or even come into five-point star with your hands, your arms at 45-degree angle and your feet really wide. And just take up space as though you're trying to expose your entire front body to that open, expansive sky. Let your eyes close. Take a deep inhale. And as you exhale, slowly let the air release. And now let your breath soften. And bring your awareness to the center of the palms of your hands. And imagine, without even moving your fingers, of your palm unfurling. Feel that sensation of unfurling in the center of your hand. And then feel into the awareness of your elbow and that eye of the elbow facing up to the sky. That joint is open. And your shoulder joints, as though you can feel space between the bones in your joint. And then bring awareness into your heart center. Feel spaciousness and freedom, openness, open to possibilities. And now just allow yourself to rest here as your body integrates all the work you just did.
without moving anything in your body. Bring your awareness to the heart center once again. Feel that openness. Bring awareness to your belly center. Bring awareness to the pelvis. Notice if you feel some freedom there. To your hip creases, your hip flexors. Feeling open and light. Bring awareness to your entire front body. And see if you can find the outline of your body in your mind's eye, where your skin, the perimeter of your body, meets the air. Feeling a lightness. Slowly begin to bring some movement into fingers and toes, and whenever you feel ready, bend your knees so that the soles of the feet can come to the mat, and roll into fetal position and pause there for a moment. And then press and rise up on an inhale. Come to a seat. And take a moment in whatever form of seat you have chosen to take here and reestablish your connection to the earth and also your connection to sky. Let your eyes closed if they have opened. And as much as your lower body grounds to the solid surface beneath you, that rootedness allows you to rise up away from the earth, like a tree branches reaching to the sky, into the air, to find movement in the wind, to dance in that sunlight. Imagine your whole upper body, the crown of your head, like those leaves gently moving in the breeze. The air dancing through, around, and amongst each leaf. Feeling a lightness in the movement. Feel a buoyancy in your heart center as you inhale. And feeling the stability as you exhale. Just sit here with eyes closed for another moment with all the sensations of being light yet grounded, being open and spacious, and slowly bring your hands to your heart center, honoring the self within, Take an inhale here. Exhale. Slowly float your eyes open. Namaste. Thank you for joining me. Have an amazing day, and we'll see you on your mat at your next practice.